Now, for decades, Sir Nicholas Winton kept a secret. During the Second World War, he had helped rescue more than 600 children, most of them Jewish, from Czechoslovakia after the Nazis invaded the country in 1939. It wasn't until half a century later, after the war, that the part played by Sir Nicholas came to light when his wife found a scrapbook filled with details of the rescues. He died last year, aged 106. And today, a special service will be held in his memory, attended by some of those that he helped. Richard Galpin reports.
A mother kisses her child goodbye at Prague train station in early 1939. Young boys and girls heading to Britain to escape the Nazi invasion of Czechoslovakia and the subsequent persecution of the Jewish and other minority communities. And the man behind their rescue, Nicholas Winton, a young London stockbroker. But first he needed permission from the British government.
When I went to the Home Office and said, look, all I want to do is to bring in unaccompanied children from Czechoslovakia who are in danger of their life into this country, is it possible? They said, we'll send you tomorrow our list of conditions. Of course it's possible. And they gave us the conditions, and 3 months later we started operating.
His kinder transport operation saved 669 children, but he kept quiet about it for decades, the documents locked away in his attic.
This is his scrapbook. Back here, you will see, is the list of all the children and the foster families who took them in.
But finally, in 1988, Esther Ranson publicised what he'd done on her TV show, That's Life, bringing him together with some of those he'd rescued. There was a big response to this, with more who'd been saved and their children coming forward.
Is there anyone in our audience tonight who owes their life to Nicholas Winton? If so, could you stand up, please?
It's estimated at least 5,000 people are alive today because of what Nicholas Winton did.
It was really just, you know, his ethical beliefs that if he didn't, they would all die. He'd seen the march of Hitler through Europe, and he was convinced that there were large chunks of the population at risk, and if he didn't do something, that would be the end for them.
That was my number 252.
92-year-old Kurt Tausig still remembers vividly the train journey from Prague to London. He went on to become a distinguished Spitfire pilot in the RAF. He describes Nicholas Winton as a godlike figure.
I owe everything to him, and so does the rest of the family and every other child. Everything. Without him, nothing would have happened. I wouldn't have been in the Air Force. I wouldn't have become what I was.
Mr. Tausig will be amongst several dozen of those saved by Nicholas Winton who will attend today's memorial service. It'll be a celebration of an extraordinary life. Richard Galpin, BBC News.